Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and failures, and ask God's pardon and forgiveness to participate in this Holy Mass in a worthy manner.
God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, whose providence never fails in its design, keep from us, we humbly beseech you, all that might harm us, and grant all that works for our good, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
For the first reading, kindly turn to page 454 from the Old Testament. Page 454, Tobit chapter 12, verses 1, 5 to 15 and 20. Tobit called his son Tobias and said to him, "My son, see to the wages of the man who went with you, and he must also be given more." So he called the angel and said to him, "Take half of all that you two have brought back." Then the angel called the two of them privately and said to them, "Praise God and give thanks to him. Exalt him and give thanks to him in the presence of all the living for what he has done for you. It is good to praise God and to exalt his name, worthily declaring the works of God. Do not be slow to give him thanks. It is good to guard the secret of a king, but gloriously to reveal the works of God. Do good, and evil will not overtake you. Prayer is good when accompanied by fasting, almsgiving, and righteousness. A little with righteousness is better than much with wrongdoing. It is better to give alms than to treasure up gold. For almsgiving delivers from death, and it will purge away every sin. Those who perform deeds of charity and of righteousness will have fullness of life, but those who commit sin are the enemies of their own lives. I will not conceal anything from you. I have said, it is good to guard the secret of a king, but gloriously to reveal the works of God. And so, When you and your daughter-in-law, Sarah, prayed, I brought a reminder of your prayer before the Holy One. And when you buried the dead, I was likewise present with you. When you did not hesitate to rise and leave your dinner in order to go and lay out the dead, your good deed was not hidden from me, but I was with you. So now God sent me to heal you and your daughter-in-law Sarah. I am Raphael, one of the seven holy angels who present the prayers of the saints and enter into the presence of the glory of the Holy One. And now give thanks to God, for I am ascending to him who sent me. Write in a book everything that has happened. The word of the Lord. Response: Blessed be God who lives forever. By turns he punishes and pardons. He sends men down to the depths of the underworld and draws them up from supreme destruction. No one can escape his hand. Response: Blessed be God who lives forever. If you return to him with all your heart and all your soul, behaving honestly towards him, then he will return to you and hide his face from you no longer. Response: Consider how well he has treated you. Loudly give him thanks. Bless the Lord of justice and extol the King of the ages. Response: I, for my part, sing his praise. In the country of my exile, I make his power and greatness known to a nation that has sinned. Response: Sinners, return to him. Let your conduct be upright before him. Perhaps he will be gracious to you and take pity on you. Response: Gospel acclamation.
Number 586. 586.
God has spoken to his people. Alleluia. And his words are words of wisdom. Alleluia.
My soul is waiting for the Lord. I count on his word.
God has spoken to his people. Alleluia. And his words are words of wisdom. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. Chapter 12, verses from 38 to 44. As he taught them, he said, Watch out for the teachers of the law who like to walk around in their long robes and be greeted with respect in the marketplace, who choose the reserved seats in the synagogues and the best places at feasts. They take advantage of widows and rob them of their homes and then make a show of saying long prayers. Their punishment will be all the worse. As Jesus sat near the temple treasury, he watched the people as they dropped in their money. Many rich men dropped in a lot of money. Then a poor widow came along and dropped in two little copper coins worth about a penny. He called his disciples together and said to them, I tell you that this poor widow put more in the offering box than all the others. For others put in what they had to spare for their riches, but she, poor as she is, put in all she had. She gave all she had to live on. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Lord Jesus Christ.
In today's gospel, Jesus clearly speaks against the misuse of religion when he says, "Beware of the scribes." They are wanting in matters of religion and faith. They know the truth, but they do not follow it. They interpret the scriptures according to their convenience for their own advantage. Their piety is but external, directed towards the prophet. They make a show of their piety in order to be honored by men. And what will be their reward? And Jesus says their reward will be very severe when they receive it, and they will be punished by God. And whoever acts the same like the scribes and the Pharisees, their reward would be similar. This is the question we have to ask ourselves today. What about our piety? What is our relationship with God and with money? Do we not use religion for our own selfish motives, for our selfishness? And have we any right to claim our superiority over other religion when we ourselves do not practice it properly, and we ourselves do not have that piety in ourselves? And what right have we to pinpoint at the other and correct them? And our love for our neighbor must be with love and service. Are we aware of that? The scribes pretended to be holy, and they appeared before people to be holy by saying the long prayers. And Jesus had warned us not to be showy in our prayers. He said, when you pray, go into your room, shut the door, and pray to the Father who is in secret. And God will give you the reward who observe you, whatever you do in secret. The scribes shamelessly used religion to enrich themselves. And the example of a widow, if you see, the widow in today's gospel, as Jesus mentioned, we see a selfless trust in the widow who gives all that she possesses, not to make a show, but to dedicate herself totally to God, because she knows God is the source of all that is good. And whatever she had, she offered to God, because it is God who gives us everything. And she knows it is not the money that would save her, but God himself. And what she had to possess is God and treasure in heaven, which is not perishable. And through her example, she shows to the world that we need to amass treasures not on earth but in heaven. And Jesus wanted his disciples to be humble and simple, not only in their appearances but also in their behavior. It is very easy to utter some prayers and to speak some good things about God to others, but it is very difficult to practice it. And all that you do, let it be done in love and service, says the St. Francis de Sales. And we need to implement this by our practical way of life, not through just lip service where we utter some good words and recite some prayers, but that should be shown in our behavior and in our concrete actions. And let us collect treasure in heaven, which neither the moth nor the rust can destroy. The treasure which God gives us is everlasting, and that is imperishable, and that would give us ultimate joy and happiness.
Hymn number 221, 221.
All for you, Lord, all for you.
Dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and good of all His holy Church.
Trusting in your compassion, O Lord, we come eagerly with our offerings to your sacred altar, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer, to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim,
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have saved.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thumabal, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And we pray for late Pelagia, Joseph, Norbert de Souza, Emmanuel, Devasagayam, and Sharada, S. Luther Reddy, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior gave us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your
spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy.
Hymn number 356, on page number 100, 356.
We celebrate this festive day with prayer and joyful song. Our Father's house is home to us. We know that we belong. The bread is broken, wine is poured, the feast to lift us up. Free.
Lord of Christ, sanctify me.
Lord of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, save me. Lord of the Son of Christ, wash me. Act on my speaking. O Jesus, hear me. Renew your own life me. Suffer me not to be separated from you. Honor and guide
me. Defend me.
And give all my health to God.
And give me unto you. That is your saints and praise you for all eternity.
Amen.
Please turn to page 235. Preparation to the Immaculate Heart of Mary. I, a faithless sinner, renew and ratify today in thy hands, O Immaculate Mother, the vows of my baptism. I renounce Satan, his pomps and works, and I give myself entirely to Jesus Christ, the incarnate wisdom, to carry my cross after him all the days of my life, and to be more faithful to him than I have ever been before. In the presence of all the heaven court, I choose thee this day for my mother and mistress. I deliver and consecrate to thee as thy slave my body and soul, my goods both interior and exterior, and even the value of all my good actions, past, present, and future, leaving to thee the entire and full right of disposing of me and all that belongs to me, without exception, according to thy good pleasure, for the greater glory of God, in time and eternity. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Let us pray. Governed by your Spirit, we pray, O Lord, those you feed with the body and blood of your Son, that professing you not just in word or in speech, but also in works and in truth, we may merit to enter the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is celebrated. Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Immaculate Mary, your praises we sing. You reign now with Jesus, our Savior and King. Amen.